Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel All About VA. So in this session we are quickly going to see how to log the error message that is happening while doing some activities, right, to a file, okay, CSV file or text file using a copy activity. Okay, a couple of session ago, around session number 63, right, we saw how to log the error information from a pipeline to a CSV file using data flow parameter. Okay, while discussing that itself, I told you we can easily implement this particular functionality using a copy activity itself. Okay, that's what I'm going to show today, because data flow parameter, it's somewhat tricky. Okay, but if you use a copy activity, right, it's going to be all simple. Okay, that's what I'm going to tell you. Before I tell you, I'll just tell you the outline of the pipeline that we are going to work today. Okay, so there is a lookup activity, which is nothing but it is pointing to my lookup file in Azure Blob Storage Path, and then the lookup file is like this. Okay, it is nothing but I'm having the details of source table and destination table. So my aim is I have to migrate set of tables from on-premise location, on-premise SQL Server, to Azure SQL Server. Okay, while if I have to migrate, right, I have to know which is my source table and which is my destination table. So that is what I'm saving in this particular lookup file. Okay, every time the lookup activity execute, it will have all the details of the records present here. Okay, and then this is going to be given to the for each loop, which is present next to the lookup file. So this for each loop is going to loop through the records that are brought by the lookup activity. Okay, so every time it loops through the record, it has access to the source table name and the destination table name. Okay, if you see the settings here, we are just accessing the output of the lookup activity, and once you have the output of the lookup activity, you will have access to the source table and the destination table. Okay, using that we can perform the copy activity, because for a copy activity all that is needed is a source and the destination. Okay, so that is brought by the for each loop, and that is what is being used in the copy activity. So when you look at the copy activity here, the setting is very simple. Okay, the source, if you check, it is the source table column that is brought by the for each loop, and then if you click on sync, right, it is we are using the destination table property of the for each loop. Okay, so the same thing, migrating records from on-premise to Azure SQL Server, right, we have discussed in session number 61 and 62. Okay, if you want to know more about it, please watch those videos. Okay, so coming back here, in case while we copy the record from on-premise to SQL Server, Azure SQL database, right, if some error happens, we can easily capture it using the copy data activity. Okay, so for that, what I have to do is I have to add a error flow, failure flow. Okay, once you added that failure, you will see this red box here. So connect the red box to the second data activity. So I will, this is copy data 1, which is nothing but the actual migration of data from on-premise to cloud, and this is whatever error happens during the copy data activity, right, that is going to be captured and logged into a CSV file or text file. Okay, so for this particular copy data activity, again we have to tell the source and sync. Okay, but the actual source of this particular copy activity is nothing but the error message coming from this particular copy activity. In the sense, copy data 2 has to access the error message of copy data 1, and that is going to be the source for it. Okay, but we can't tell use the error message from the copy data 1. We should be giving some connection. Okay, dummy file at least we have to give it. So I will say use the lookup file as the source. Even though I say use lookup file as source, right, we are not going to pull any column from the lookup file. It's for namesake, I'm pointing to the lookup file. Okay, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this additional columns, okay, in order to capture my error message. Okay, so if I say error message, right, this is one additional column that in which we are going to capture the error. We have to add the dynamic value. So whenever the pipeline runs and something goes wrong, right, we have to capture that only using the dynamic expression. In our case, whenever the copy data 1 fails, right, we have to capture the error. So I'm clicking the activity output and changing the output to error.message. Okay, so this is what it will do is every time the copy data 1 fails, it is going to access the error property and the message property. Okay, so error message column is going to have the value captured from the copy data activity. Okay, while error happens, if there is no error, then this activity will not be executed at all. Alright, so this is all about my source setting. What I did is I just pointed to a dummy file and then I added a additional column. This additional column is what is going to be returned to the destination table. Okay, destination file. I'll show you that. Okay, so go to sync and I'm saying a blob storage data set. It'll ask for a file name and say errorlog.csv. Okay, and then that's all. We need not do any mapping or any kind of logging here. Okay, so whenever an error happens, what it is going to do is it is going to see in order for you to verify that whether it will map correctly or it will capture the additional column correctly, you can quickly come to mapping tab and then click on import. Once you click on import, right, you will be asked to provide a dummy value for the additional expression. Okay, I'm just saying empty string and I'm saying okay. Okay, this is not actually needed. You can skip this mapping altogether. Okay, but if you want to verify what is how is the mapping handled internally, you can click on import and then you will be able to see the error message that we have added in the source. Okay, all right, I'm going to run the pipeline. And it is going to fail. I'll tell you why it's going to fail. Okay, so whenever we are trying to access Azure SQL table, right, it will be validating the IP address that is trying to reach it. Okay, in our case, my laptop's IP address will be verified if it has access to the SQL Azure SQL database. Okay, only if you have added your IP address to the firewall settings of the Azure SQL database, you will be able to access the Azure SQL database. Otherwise, your pipeline cannot run. Okay, or any activity within the pipeline, if it tries to access the SQL table, right, it's going to fail. So since I haven't added my IP address to the firewall settings yet, it's going to fail every time it's trying to reach the Azure SQL table. So in our case, it's going to try two times, okay, because we have two entries in the lookup table, and then it tries two times to reach the file and it fails. See here, when you see the error message, you will understand it. Okay, so what it is telling is client with IP address, this particular IP address, is not able to access the server. Okay, so this is what the error that is occurring while the copy activity executes. Okay, so the same error is going to be captured by the copy activity 2 that we have implemented, and it is going to be returned to the error log file. Okay, I'm just checking the blob storage path whether it has been written correctly. Refresh it and then try to look at the error log file. See here, two files were there, I mean two records were there, one is DIM customer and DIM product, and whatever error has happened in both the copy activities, it has been logged. Okay, the same error whatever we saw in the pipeline, right, the same error has been logged. Okay, that is how we capture the error message from a pipeline and log it to the CSV file or text file in the blob storage path. Okay, the same way you can log your error messages to a table also in SQL Server. Okay, so in case you have any doubts about this particular session, please let me know in the comment section. Otherwise, if you like my videos and you haven't subscribed, please subscribe to my channel. Thanks a lot.